What if I were to tell you that a severe back injury was the best thing that has ever happened to me? I know it sounds crazy, but let me explain. My name's Nick Venuti, and today's video is a personal story about discovery, pain, transformation, and just all the things that can happen to you in really a blink of an eye. It all started when I was a cook in the kitchen, when we were cleaning up at the end of the night, and one of the coolers started to move into the drain. And my first reaction was to brace and try to catch it so everything didn't fall out. And as soon as I went to turn and brace for it, I felt a pop immediately in my back. And I was like, we'll worry about that in the morning. And when I woke up that next day, I couldn't get out of bed. Everything was just so stiff. I had tingling feelings going down from the top of my pelvis all the way down to my heel. Every time I tried to take a deep breath, it was excruciating pain. And so obviously I had to call off work. And for some of you, if you don't know, one of the number one reasons people call off in America is because of back pain. So something to consider. But I started to feel old. I was 24, 25 at that time, and I figured something's got to give. And over the course of a couple weeks, it started to feel better, but I couldn't work out anymore. I couldn't play hockey. I couldn't do the things that I wanted to do. So I decided, let me go to a chiropractor, right? Isn't that what most people do when you have a severe back injury? So they told me it was caused by an anterior pelvic tilt, and they said it was basically because I was just having long hours over a kitchen, cutting on a cutting board, over the stove, playing hockey. I'm in this position. They were trying. Workouts, the wobble chair, the stretches, and doing all these snapping me. They're cracking me, they're popping me, and this feels good whenever I'm in the clinic, but as soon as I would get into my car, I'm back into this rounded shoulder, overflexed position that they were just yelling at me about. And so I realized at the chiropractor or at the doctor's office, it's about what you're doing at home, at the gym, or in your own space. And so that led me down the road of YouTube. I was looking for an answer. I was lost. None of my friends knew how to deal with back pain. I grew up in a town where it was either drugs, crime, or that was it. You know, you pick one of those two things and that's who you are. And so there wasn't really any fitness professionals. There wasn't really any doctors in the circle that you can really talk to. I'm sure some of you can relate to this, that you're looking online for a solution. And sometimes those are the best solutions. Just typed in yoga for guys, beginner, and found a channel, Yoga with Tim. Yoga with Tim was the first yoga video that I have ever even tried to do. And I started finding relief from it. And it was crazy. It was maybe 2 to 3 weeks. I'm like, wow, I can actually touch my shins. I couldn't even touch below my knees when I was dealing with this back pain. And so over the course of time, I decided, all right, I'm gonna start doing this yoga class with Tim every morning. And it was the same video every day. And I said, let me start doing some core work. And they were telling me that my core was weak. I had this anterior pelvic tilt. So I started doing some of these exercises, and I would go back to the chiropractor, and he would say, oh, you know what, Nick, you are getting a little bit better. You know, these things are starting to shape up for you. Now that things are shaping up for you, your 1 year has expired. It's time for you to go on to the maintenance plan. I was like, well, how much is the maintenance plan? Oh, the maintenance plan's, $3,500 for the rest of the year. I'm not trying to spend $3,500. I'm doing this yoga, I'm figuring out this core work, and I'm not in pain anymore, so I don't think I need this maintenance plan. And so I started doing everything myself, and it was an eye-opening experience because I want to learn more about the human body. I want to know about how this is even working for me. Why is this working? Why am I starting to feel better about these positions that I'm doing in some of these poses? Why can I touch my toes all of a sudden? What is going on? And for me, I always thought I knew exercise. I would open up, health and fitness magazine and say, oh yeah, you know, 3 sets of this, 4 sets of that. Let's go ahead and implement it and not know why I'm even doing this particular exercise. I really started going down the long list of YouTube and figuring out different types of yoga poses, different types of core strengthening exercises. I would bring these to the gym, felt really confident about myself, and started seeing gains. That's when it all hit me. I gotta go back to school. I gotta figure how this is really working for myself, and so I can teach other people that there is a way out of back pain. There is a way that you can do things yourself that don't require medical interventions. Kind of circle back a little bit. I never graduated high school. I was kicked out of high school because I had a pack of rolling papers in my wallet, and they apparently thought that I was this big drug addict. Now, I'd like to smoke a joint every here and there, but it was an overreaction. So they kicked me out of school. And my dad said, you got to figure out how to work. You got to go to work. You got to do something. And so I was always working in kitchens, and I was always doing these type of mundane jobs because they didn't require any education. And so I never really thought about the importance of getting my education, because I figured the kitchen was where I was going to live. One of the things that I started realizing after I suffered this injury was working long hours is probably not gonna be the best thing for me if I'm trying to recover from this injury, and especially being in all the positions that they told me not to be in. And so utilizing that, I said, there's gotta be a better way. I took the hard road of really doing some introspective work and looking at myself in the mirror and saying, you're better than this. You could do, you're capable of more. And I think a lot of times for us, we don't have that inner self-talk to really say we are capable of more, because a lot of times we let other things define us and let us be defined by somebody's other vision of ourselves. So I decided, let me go get my GED. I'm gonna study for this, and I'm gonna go ahead and really do my best effort. And the first time I did it, I passed in the 1 percentile of students who took the test. And I figured, well, I guess I'm a little bit smarter than I gave myself credit for. It was a couple weeks after that I decided, you know what? Let me go to a community college and start learning simple college education. I wasn't in school for a long period of time, and that means basic math, that means basic writing skills, that means basic everything is where I figured I'm gonna start from scratch. And so it took me 3 to 4 years to get a 2-year associate's degree, because I started from the beginning and I wanted to work while I was doing this. I put myself through school, and I figured if I'm gonna actually go ahead and follow through with this, it's got to be out of my own money, and it's got to be out of my own effort. And once I graduated with an associate's degree, I said, all right, I'm ready for this. I got a business idea. I'm going to help people. I'm going to open up a facility that's going to have a demonstration kitchen in it. We're going to have a full functioning gym. Everybody's going to come here. I'm going to feed people. We're going to exercise, and it's all going to be in one place, and this is going to be awesome. But then I started realizing that I don't have any education about how to start a business, how to do any of this stuff. And I really have a basic education of how the body works. And so I decided the University of Pittsburgh is a prestigious school, and so let me sign up here. UPMC is University of Pittsburgh Medical Center, is one of the best hospitals. So let me learn from these people, and basically write into the University of Pittsburgh and said, hey, this is my story, this is what I want to do, and I want to help people, and I think that your education can help me do that. They accepted me, which, again, coming from kicked out of high school, GED, Community College of Allegheny County, and then now the University of Pittsburgh, all because of this back injury. And that's something to really look at, and that's kind of from the very beginning, was this simple act changed my life. There's these little things that pop up in our life, and we don't realize what that does and what you can do from that. Even if it is just a simple moment, even if it is just a simple idea, a lot of times we have to take these signs and go with them. And for me, I took this sign of back pain going through the healthcare system, of seeing why they really want to put a Band-Aid on your injury. They don't want to necessarily help you. Here's a pill. Here's this. Here's that. It's about what you're doing outside of that healthcare facility, trying to get yourself out of pain. If I can help people before they get to the point where they're going down the healthcare industry and they're just basically the snowball effect of here, try this, try that. I don't know. We don't know. Do something. Here's a pill. If I could help people before they get to that point, that was the whole reason of me going back to school, me going back to starting the Healthy Ends, or me starting this business, was because I saw that there was a need for it. And people started asking me, what the hell is going on? Nick, how are you? You're looking good. You were just in pain. And how can we do this? And throughout the years, knowing my why going to school, I think the most important thing, because it kept me focused, it kept me grounded. I went from making, you know, $60,000 a year to making $15,000 struggling because I'm going to school. Everything that I was paying for was going to school. I wasn't making any money because I wasn't working in the kitchen. I was working in the university. I was doing simple $10 an hour jobs, you know, and taking that hit is something I'm still dealing with to this day. Let's be real. But it's one of those things that I knew. It's part of the level up factor. Sometimes you got to put yourself into a scary position in order to build yourself up to get out to the other side to see that there's a lot more out there. As soon as I graduated, I started the business. That's when the Healthy Yinzer came, and people a lot of times are wondering, what the hell is the Healthy Yinzer? And so Yinzer, being from Pittsburgh, that is just kind of what they call us. Pittsburgh's not really the healthiest of towns either. We put French fries on our salads, which it's good, but it's not the healthiest thing in the world. We put French fries on our sandwiches. It's good, but it ain't the healthiest thing in the world. So I figured this is a good spin. I can help people with their food because I am a chef my whole life. I can help people now get out of pain because I have learned the biomechanics. I have learned the exercise physiology that it takes to get somebody out of pain. And I've done it myself. I've been there. I've experienced it. I was able to use these different modalities to help inspire other people. And I think that's really the whole reason of this video, was that a lot of times we don't realize that it's these little things that come up that is what's really gonna make you who you are today. Now, I would have never thought that me just trying to catch a Kohler was gonna be the catapult for the rest of my life. I figured I'm gonna be in pain for the rest of my life. But the power of self-belief and the power of overcoming doubts can transform you into a person that you never even thought was possible. My journey is a testament of power of persistence, belief, knowing that transformation is in reach. And now that you've heard my story, I'd love to be a part of yours. Let me know in the comments. Let's connect. Let's share. Let me know about your transformation. Let me know about some of the things that you've been dealing with in life. And, you know, let's make a plan. Let's do it.